Dellen, Millard, and Mark Smich found guilty of first-degree murder of Laura Babcock. That, again, coming from Trevor Dunn of CBC News, who is in the courtroom right now, breaking news that these two, who had been charged with first-degree murder of 23-year-old Laura Babcock, who had not been seen since 2012, have been found guilty of first-degree murder charges. That comes with an automatic life sentence, Michael. He's also saying that the Babcock family is in the courtroom right now. They are crying. He could hear them whispering yes as the verdict was being read. Millard looks towards them and he's shaking his head. So we're waiting for more information to come in. He's just tweeted again from our colleague Trevor Dunn. Jury being asked individually if they agree with the verdict. Some are weeping, some having difficulty confirming the verdict. But we do have, according to Trevor, a guilty verdict for both of these men. Now, just to remind folks about the story that we have been covering here on CBC News Network, these two men, 32-year-old Dellen Millard, 30-year-old Mike Smich, friends from Toronto and Oakville, were presented by the Crown as the key suspects, as the two men who were responsible for the disappearance and what they said was the murder of this young woman, Laura Babcock. They attributed, as they moved forward with the trial, that Babcock had been entangled in some sort of love triangle, and then she had to be removed from the equation, which is why these two men plotted and then carried through her death. It was a gruesome trial. The details were very disturbing. There were allegations presented by the Crown that, in fact, these two men had plotted it. They had coerced her to come to their home. They had killed her. They held on to her phone. In fact, her phone and her iPad were eventually located by the police at their home. They bought an incinerator, did research on how to destroy a human body. These details were incredibly gruesome. And then to add cruelty to all of this, beyond everything else, they rapped about it. They sang about it. One of them is an aspiring rap artist and wrote lyrics about murdering a woman and burning her body and throwing it in the lake. All of this was presented during the trial by the Crown, indicating that they believed these two men had carried out the murder.
And really, we have been waiting for this verdict now for several days, because this trial began October the 23rd, but it was on Tuesday, 2 p.m., that essentially the jury began their deliberations regarding this case. I'm going to ask you to go through once more the social media feed to see if, what else we're getting from Trevor Dunn, as Trevor Dunn is our reporter in that courtroom. Important to note, though, and this wasn't shared during the trial itself as it wasn't allowed to be presented, but both Millard and Smich have already been convicted in the death of Tim Bosma, that murder conviction coming in June of 2016. Again, that was not shared in the court during the trial itself and the presentation of facts and arguments. So they have already been convicted of murder. Again, they're now found guilty in this case. And we have to say we're also waiting for Dellen Millard, as he's still facing first-degree murder charges in relation to the death of his father, Wayne Millard. Again, this is, you're looking at Dellen, pictures of Dellen Millard, and right now Mike Smich there. I'm wondering what else we're hearing at this moment in time from Trevor, though. Again, our reporter in the courtroom, Natasha.
So we're hearing from Trevor that all of the jurors do agree to the verdict. The judge has thanked them, and they have been asked to leave the room. Some of the jury members are weeping right now, Michael. And that is understandable. Some of us have been following closely the details of this case. It was incredibly gruesome. We have to also remind folks that Laura Babcock's body was never retrieved. And the Crown said it would never be retrieved because these two men had burned it in an incinerator they bought specifically for this purpose. They had named the incinerator the Exterminator. They had researched how to incinerate a body, how to get rid of the smell. This was all presented over the course of the trial. So the police never were able to pinpoint the evidence of this is Laura's body and these two men are responsible for it. But when the remains of what was in the incinerator were finally looked at through by a forensic anthropologist, that anthropologist was able to confirm those were certainly human remains. And so that, again, became very, very strong evidence for the Crown. Then beyond that, we know that Dellen Millard, who was involved in that love triangle with Laura Babcock and another woman, had written a letter to the other woman more or less confessing that he was going to remove Laura Babcock from the equation. And he asked that other woman, don't say anything, I'm trusting you with this information. all of that evidence came out, all of that incredibly damning as the trial moved forward. We're still waiting for more information to come in, but the jury is has rendered their verdict.
But important to say that, again, that the breaking news and the headline at this moment in time is the fact that both Millard and Smich have been found guilty of first-degree murder, all in the relation to the death of this woman, Laura Babcock, as we say, 23 years old at the time that she disappeared back in 2012. Her body, as Natasha told us, was never found. And there were these romantic links that were talked about during the trial itself. I'm wondering now about sentencing, though. Yes, they are now guilty of first-degree murder. What about the sentencing that these two men face?
Well, we know that first-degree murder automatically comes with a life sentence, but that officially, of course, has to go through the process of the judge saying you'll be getting a life sentence. How this is...
Which is 25 years in this country.
Yes, so lifetime sentence, first option for parole at 25 years. Does that get complicated by the fact that these two men have already been found guilty on the first-degree murder of another individual, Tim Bosma, 32 years old. He disappeared from Ancaster, Ontario. Reportedly, he was trying to sell his pickup truck to these two men, lured away. And again, they were found guilty of killing him. So there's that to take into the equation. There is also the ongoing investigation and the charges that Millard faces about the first-degree murder of his own father. All of that has to be taken into account. I mean, now you've got two men found guilty, first-degree murder on both counts. I don't know if we've ever been in a situation like this where you're found guilty, but the cases are two completely separate trials and investigations, Michael.
And we have to say at this point that the Crown, and we're getting this from Trevor again, the Crown is seeking consecutive sentences with the Bosma conviction. So he's not looking for concurrent, but he's actually looking one after the other. The Crown is looking for one after the other in terms of a life sentence. Also, at this point, they are discussing when a sentencing hearing will take place. But here we are towards the end of the season for many people. As we approach the holiday season, chances are this is not going to be dealt with in terms of the actual sentence in 2017.
No, it likely won't, and it might happen in the new year, but as I was saying, this is a moot point for many people. There's already been a conviction on the books with that other trial related to the Tim Bosma murder. Now we've got a case of Millard having to face the first-degree murder charge of his own father, and many people were wondering how quickly the jury would come to a decision on this. In fact, some had suspected that the minute the jurors went in after the trial concluded, we anticipated that the verdict would come very quickly because of the amount of investigation done by the Crown and the police, the amount of evidence that was gathered. Yes, the critical bit of information that they needed, a body, they did not have. But everything else certainly pointed in that direction, and that's certainly what the jurors must have felt as well. They did need to go through some of the information. They had asked the judge to go through some of those details, go through the review process on Wednesday. We know that did not conclude until Thursday, and so we weren't sure how quickly this would wrap up, but it did take them, I believe, about 4 or 5 days to reach this verdict, longer than it certainly took the jury when it came to the Tim Bosma case. They came to that decision fairly quickly.
And to the point of the sentence, this is again from Trevor Dunn. He says, the Crown says jury in the murder trial can decide between consecutive or concurrent sentence here. So the jury is being asked once again to return to the courtroom. So obviously the story is still not done. We keep tracking it. But I'm going to thank you right now, Natasha. But the headline at this moment in time is that Dellen, Millard and Smich have been convicted of first-degree murder.